Here, several items inventory model with constraints will be discussed. In this particular video, we will have EOQ model with floor space constraint on examples. EOQ model, that is classical economic order quantity model, or EOQ model with shortages, or EOQ model with finite or infinite replenishment rate, deals with single item. In general, the inventory system stocks several items. For example, if we consider shopping mall or grocery shop, they have huge number of items. Not only shopping mall, even the kitchen stocks several items. One can study each item individually as long as there is no interaction among the items. There can be many sorts of interactions among the items. Namely, warehouse capacity may be limited and items are competing for floor space, or there may be an upper limit on the number of units to be purchased, or there may be an upper limit on the maximum investment in inventory. There are many more constraints which one can think of, but we will talk about floor space constraint in this particular video. Assumptions are production or supply is instantaneous with no lead time. That means replenishment rate is infinite. Demand is uniform and deterministic. That is, demand is known and constant. And shortages are not allowed. Suppose that there are n items to be stored in an inventory system. For jth item, demand rate is rj, purchase cost is cj, ordering cost or replenishment cost is aj, inventory carrying charge fraction per unit per annum is ij, and order quantity is QJ and is a decision variable. The average annual cost per time unit for all the units is given by TC equal to TC of each item, that is QJ, J runs from 1 to N, is equal to summation J running from 1 to N, holding cost and ordering cost. Holding cost for jth item is half cj ij qj, and ordering cost is aj rj upon qj. Then the optimal lot size for jth item is qj0 equal to square root 2 aj rj upon cj into ij, where j is equal to 1 to n, and corresponding total minimum cost of an inventory system for all n items is TC0 equal to sigma j running from 1 to n square root 2 aj cj ij into rj. Now let us have floor space constraint and EOQ model. Suppose that there is an upper limit, say F, of the square meters of warehouse floor space, and jth item requires Fj square meter of floor space. So, total floor space required by Qj items is sigma j running from 1 to n Fj Qj and it is bounded by F. If the QJ equal to square root 2J AJ RJ upon CJ IJ satisfies floor space constraint, then QJ0 is optimal procurement quantity and the total minimum cost is TC0 is equal to sigma j running from 1 to n square root 2aj cj ij rj. On the other hand, if total space consumed by QJ units is more than the available floor space, then QJ0 given by 2AJ RJ upon CJ into IJ is not optimum. So, we want to minimize the average total cost per time unit for all n items subject to the floor space constraint and non-negativity of the procurement quantity. We construct the non-negative Lagrange's function as L of Qj comma lambda equal to objective function, which is total cost, plus lambda times floor constraint, that is sigma j running from 1 to n fj qj minus f. Here this lambda is non-negative Lagrange multiplier. What is importance of this lambda? Lambda indicates additional cost related to floor space used by each unit of the item. Now we want to optimize this Lagrange's function with respect to QJ and lambda. Then, concurrent necessary conditions for L to be minimum are partial derivative of L with respect to QJ is to be equated to 0. And with some algebraic computation, we get QJ equal to square root 2AJ RJ upon CJ IJ plus 2 lambda FJ. And when partial derivative of Lagrangian function with respect to Lagrangian multiplier is equated to 0, it gives floor constraint, that is sigma j running from 1 to n fj qj is equal to f. Now here question comes how to get the value of lambda, and for that we will use trial and error method to get the optimum value of lambda. But yes, we can have one clue from the expression of QJ. QJ and lambda, that is Lagrangian multiplier, are inversely related. So if QJs are more than the required one, you can reduce or you can decrease the value of lambda and vice versa. We'll see that in example. A small shop produces three machine parts, say 1, 2 and 3 in lots. The shop has only 1000 square feet of storage space. Data for three items are given in the following table. Demand rate R for machine parts 1, 2 and 3 are 3000, 2500 and 5000 units. Purchase cost per unit is rupees 10, 15 and 5 respectively. Ordering costs per order are 100, 200 and 75 respectively. Floor space required by machine part 1 is 0.70 square feet. By part 2 it is 0.80 square feet. and by part 3 it is 0.40 square feet. The shop usage and inventory carrying charge of 15% of average inventory valuation per year. If no stockouts are allowed, determine the optimal lot size for each item under the given storage constraints. So we want to find out Q1, Q2 and Q3 optimum procurement quantity for machine part 1, 2 and 3 provided we use 1000 square feet of floor space only. Let us start with lambda is equal to 1 and compute Q1, Q2, Q3 using formula under root 2 aj rj upon cj ij plus 2 lambda fj. Substitute the values of a, r, c, I and F, we get Q1 is equal to 454 units, Q2 is equal to 509 units and Q3 is equal to 695 units. Now let us see how much is the floor space occupied by Q1, Q2 and Q3. The floor space occupied is sigma j running from 1 to n, Fj, Qj. Machine part 1 uses 0.70 square feet and total 454 units are procured. So total floor space required by machine part 1 is 0.70 into 454 plus 0.80 plus 509 for machine part 2 and plus 0.40 into 695, that turns out to be 1003 square feet, which is nearer to given floor space of 1000 square feet. So Q1 is equal to 454 units, Q2 equal to 509 units and Q3 is equal to 695 units are sufficient to purchase and they can be stored in the available floor space of 1000 square feet. Let us have one more example. Three machines are produced by a factory in lots. A factory has floor space of 600 square feet. The demand rate, purchase cost, ordering cost and floor space required are given in the table. You can see that demand rate for machine part 1, 2 and 3 are 50,000, 2,000 and 10,000 respectively. Purchase costs are 20 rupees, 15 rupees and 10 rupees respectively. Ordering costs 100 rupees, 150 rupees and 200 rupees respectively. Floor space required by machine 1 is 0.60 square feet, by machine 2 is 0.75 square feet and by machine 3 it is 0.30 square feet. The factory uses an inventory carrying charge at 20% of average inventory per year. If no shortages are allowed, determine the optimal lot size for each item under given floor constraint of 600 square feet. Let us see the solution. We start with lambda equal to 1 and using formula Qj is equal to square root 2aj rj upon cj into yj plus 2 lambda fj gives Q1 is equal to 438 units, Q2 is equal to 365 units and Q3 is equal to 1240 units. The floor occupied is 0.60 into 438 plus 0.75 into 365 plus 0.30 into 1240. So that turns out to be 908 square feet. But we only have 600 square feet available. So we need to go with some higher value of lambda. Let us start with lambda is equal to 3. Then Q1 is 362 units, Q2 is equal to 282 units, and Q3 turns out to be 1025 units. And with this units, the floor space occupied is 0.60 into 362 units plus 0.75 into 282 units plus 0.30 into 1025 units, and that turns out to be 736 square feet. But this is also much higher than what we have as a 600 square feet. So we increase lambda to 6 and find Q1 is equal to 299 units, Q2 is equal to 223 units, and Q3 is equal to 845 units. And with this units, the total floor space is 600.15 square feet, and which is very close to given floor space. So we should consider purchase of 299 units for machine 1, 223 units for machine 2, and 845 units for machine 3. That will minimize the total cost of an inventory system. Thank you.